designing concept and the basic concepts of the DFT, FFT. Now we are going to discuss the concepts of the implementation in this lecture. And in this lecture, we also try to cover the some basic concepts which we have discussed during the time of the design and the realization of the filters as well as the DFT and the FFT. So today we'll discuss about the design and implementation of the filters and the systems. And we will also try to cover the concepts of the MATLAB that will be used in order to design and implement the system here. So we are just starting the lecture of the today. That if we are, as we know, if we have to describe any system, then system may be said to the process, and that may be the without feedback or the with the feedback depending upon the situation. It means in the system, the system operates on the signal in order to extract the desired output. And we know that we can categorize the system in two categories. One is the digital and the second one is the analog. And we are discussing here the digital system, and particularly we are discussing the digital signal processor. And we know that for the purpose of the presentation, we can use either the block diagram for the purpose of the representation, or we can use the different types of the languages. In this DSP, we had used the block diagram representation, and for that purpose, we have used the basic elements of the adder, multiplier, and the memory elements for the purpose of the designing. And we have discussed that what is the system. In that part, we have described that it is a collection of the parts that works together to achieve a goal or the task. Or we can say the system is a set of the objects and the relationship amongst the objects viewed as a whole and the design to achieve a purpose. Here we can say the process or the system operates on the input in order to extract the output. And if we have the capacity, we have the facility to compare the performance of the output, and then again, here the processing will be modified, then that becomes the feedback system here. And whether the system in open loop or the closed loop, there is a need of the effective methodology in order to improve the performance of the system. And as we know, there is effectiveness is nothing but it is a function of the human skills, software, and the hardware. For the purpose of the developing an efficient system, we have to first of all we have to see what is the requirement, and then after getting the requirement, whatever is the requirement, that has to be converted into the practical form. So practical approaches, so whatever is the requirement, that has to be converted into the practical form by a specification by to be converted into specification. Nothing but is that we have to develop the mathematical model. Now, we are discussing the digital process during time. We are discussing like V n minus k negative sign, and from the k is equal to V n plus ak n k from the 0 to m here. Not the system. Depend on the value of the m is considered as the part of the system. And after that, here the derivation of the mathematical equation, we have to decide whether we are interested in order to design the ATI system or the AKs and PKs are and when we say FCA, nothing, we get the and here to decide what will be the response type of that design system, whether it will be the low pass filter, high pass, band pass, band stop. So at the same time, we have to also decide what the design method, whether we are interested for the moving the model or the autoregressive model, because whatever is the Michael model here we have discussed, it is the R model. So here the moving model, that is the FIR filter, and if it is the autoregressive model, then it is the IIR filter. We can say for the purpose of the harmonics analysis, there is a need of the different types of the so that we can analyze the performance in the domain as well as in the frequency domain. And we know that if we develop the differential equation, then the Laplace transform is available for the purpose of the conversion for the difference equation. Z transformation is used here. And when we in the Laplace transform, when S is replaced by Z transformation and Z is replaced by the domain, the Fourier transformation. And nature becomes analog or the continuous so here the model and if the number of computation is the number of
sir, your voice is not clear.
So here we are again trying to discuss this one because there is a problem in today. Hello, any problem?
Yes, sir, you are audible now.
Okay. So you are here in order to say inform me whether we are connected or not in the net. Yeah, Mr. Chair. Bajna. Doesn't block. Okay.
Sir, PPT is not visible.
Mr. Deja.
Yes, sir, yes.
That is there.
Sir, I am in lab. He is in a simulation lab. Sir, I am calling.
आपको कहाँ यहाँ रहने के लिए जो बताना फोन ना उठा कर सो
बता दिया
फोन साइलेंट रखो आप ओके so we have so it is visible na is it visible
but PPT is not visible
when nahi kiya hoga tab kya bethega ज्वाइन किए तो देख बताया था ज्वाइन करने से बैठे रहते हो शिक्षा पे तुम कुछ पता ही नहीं चलता क्या प्रेजेंटिंग कहाँ से आला क्लास ही नहीं है अभी
आपने किया था तुम
तो जबरदस्ती है कर उतरे उसको भेज कुछ आता है समझ ही नहीं आता क्या करना क्या नहीं आवाज आ रही
है
ज्वाइन करता है ज्वाइन था नहीं अभी
जो आप ज्वाइन है तो
अपने से कनेक्ट कर दो पता नहीं स्पीड लो स्लो
सर मेरे यहां से वहां नहीं मोबाइल हॉट स्पॉट ऑन है वहां से चेंज नहीं करना
What is whether I'm out.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir is connected from two accounts, I think, because the voice is coming to
us. देख लीजिए नाम
सर की आईडी से ही सर दो जगह से ज्वाइन
इसीलिए उनको
हेलो हेलो
यस सर
So we have discussed the designing concepts and sorry for the interruption because of the net problem. So here we have discussed the designing concepts and we have discussed these steps. That is, we had used the different type of the approximation method for the purpose of the designing using the different types of the criteria here. And then the next step is again refining the coding here. And for that purpose, we use the mixed language or the mixed coding, that is the C as well as the assembly language, for the purpose of the efficient implementation of the our concept here. Because we know the machine is very sensitive or effective to the machine language, and we feel the easier for the higher level language. So we use the mesh language, and for the do loops we use here the assembly language, and remaining portions are used using here the high level language. So this is the concept of the mixed level mixed coding, that is the efficient coding concept here. Now for the purpose of the creating the filters here, first of all we have to decide that here the theoretical concept, and then develop the mathematical model. After developing the mathematical model, we have to decide the realization or the architectural design, and then we will move towards the deciding how the coefficients will be quantized here. And after quantization, naturally the coefficients will be changed here. So we have to compute the quantized coefficients here, and then we have to decide how everything else will be quantized. That is the input, how the input samples or the signal will be quantized, how will the output will be quantized, result of the multiplications, result of the additions will be also quantized here, and they will be changed here. Now we will try to cover here the some concepts of the quantization that is related with the input, coefficients, output, multiplicand, product, and some quantization here. For the purpose of the quantization, we have to use the mode, round mode, overflow mode, and the data format. In the mode, we have to use the here the fixed mode, float mode, double mode, and single mode. During the time of the writing the code, if we write here the fixed mode, it means we are using the fixed number system representation. That is the qm.n format will be utilized for the fixed number system. And if we are using the qm.n format, it means the total word length is m plus n plus 1, because the m is used for the integer portion, n is used for the fractional portion, and the MSB will be utilized for the sign bit here. Similarly, if we write only the float in the our program, float means it is a user defined floating point number system, means what will be the number of the mantissa and what will be the number of the exponent, that will be defined by the user here. And in the floating point, again there are the two category. One is the single precision and the second one is the double precision. These are the dependent on the IEEE 754 standard. That is, if we use the single precision here, it means the 32-bit here the implementation will be utilized, and the double precision means 64-bit implementation will be utilized here. During the time of the addition and the multiplication, there is a chance to take the overflow. So in order to avoid this one, we have to use the saturation or the wrap type of the overflow mode. And for the representation of the data format, we have to use here the capital N, small n format. That is the for the fixed point number system, that is the total word length will be the capital N, and the small n is the number of the bits that will be used for the fractional number representation here. Similarly, if we are using the capital N and the E, capital N will be used for the total word length, small e will represent here the fraction, the exponential that are the total number of the bits which are used for the exponential representation. And at the same time, we have to also discuss here the round mode. During the time of the rounding, we have to use which type of the rounding will be utilized. There are the different types of the rounding, that is the seal, convergent, fixed, floor, and the round mode. And we have to decide which mode will be utilized. Then we have to go for, we are in the class, please. Yeah, so seal, wait, please. Seal, convergent, fixed, and floor around here. These are the different types of the round mode that will be used for the rounding purposes here. Now we have discussed that for the purpose of the creating the system here, we have to cover the theoretical concept, mathematical model, and functional description, architectural designing. Then we have to decide the number on what will be the realization structure. And then we have to decide what is the number of the bits that will be used in order to represent the coefficients that will be named as the quantization or the coefficient quantization. Then we have to and these are done with the help of the MATLAB. And similarly, during the time of the decision, means how everything will be quantized or what is the efficient code, and how we will test our design filter. These will be tested, or these will be done with the help of the here the CCS code composer studio, that is the interface between a designing concept and the here the target or the given starter kit, digital signal processing starter kit, that is known as the DSK kit. So here we are coming to the again to this concept, that is first step is to understand the application problem, then we have to design the algorithm according to our requirement, and that algorithm has to be converted into the implementable form, and whatever is the implementable algorithm, that has to be converted into the efficient implementation algorithm using the different types of the approaches like the pipelining, parallel processing, here the and then timing, retiming, folding, unfolding. These are the different concepts or the algorithms that can be used in order to convert the implementable algorithm into the efficient implementable algorithm here. Then that will be naturally implemented on the hardware, and for that purpose we have to use a digital signal starter kit. And that kit is nothing but it has a signal processor with the here the different types of the interfaces, so that this digital signal processor can interact with the real world. And there are the three mode of the interaction with the real world. One is the analog mode, and second one is the code, that is the and the third one is the digital mode here. And for the this purpose, we use here the TMS320C6713 digital signal processor, that is the 64-bit processor here, and having a speed of the 2 to 5 megahertz. So here and this is the designing concept here. See, this is the designing concept which we have discussed so far, and it has to be implemented on this hardware, and it is done with the help of a interface, that is the Code Composer Studio. See here, the Code Composer Studio is an interface that is responsible in order to download the designed concept on a given hardware. What are the parts of the CCS Code Composer Studio? Here the whatever is the algorithm, that is written in the form of the code, and that code will be first converted into the C code form. And here the Code Composer Studio accepts that C code, and then there is a compiler. Compiler converts this one, that is the .c will be converted into the .asm file, and then it will be considered as input to the assembler. Assembler will convert it into the .obj file, and obj file, that obj file will be considered as the input to the linker, and its output, that is the dot out or the dot, will be utilized to with the help of the simulator or the target hardware for the purpose of the implementation here. So here if we see the Code Composer Studio, then what are the different section of the Code Composer Studio? These are the compiler, assembler, linker, and these are the different section which converts the different types of the code into the such a form that finally we are getting here the dot out or the dot bin, so that it can be implemented on a given hardware or that given target here. Now suppose we are using here any type of the code, .m or the .mdl, or we are using here the any toolbox for the purpose of the designing of our system, which we have discussed and which we have also tested in our laboratory work. So it has to be implemented. So first step is to that code will be converted into the .c form. So here the RTW real time workshop is a software that will convert here the these .m, .mdl are the toolbox of process into the .c, and this CCS will accept it as the input, and finally we will get here the .out or the .bin file that will be loaded, downloaded to the target here, that is the TMS320C6713 here. So if we see in SART, means what is happening, the first step is the designing, and second one is the coding and building, and the third, in the third step we are trying to debug the code, and the, after analysis we are just downloading the concept on a given target here. Now if we use here the we know that in the MATLAB we use the different types of the coding schemes using the simulink.m file or the toolboxes here. We know that the basic kernel is the C kernel here, and using these three steps we can download our concept on a given target here. We have also discussed the designing concepts using the MATLAB here. If you see, then we will find for that purpose we have discussed the assignment, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and power. That is very simple here. And we have also discussed the scalar operations related to the summation and the product, division, and addition here. We had also discussed the vector operators using the inner product, transpose matrix, cross product, and we have also discussed the element wise operation using the MATLAB that is related to the addition, subtraction, multiplication, division here, and also for the getting the power. Using the MATLAB concept, we have also discussed here the vector or the array representation and their manipulation here, these and indexing also here. And we have, in addition of these steps, we have also gone through the sum functions like the mean, max, minimum, sum, sort, and median. Standard deviation, for standard deviation we are using the STD, determinant DT, inverse of any matrix INB, dot matrix. For the dot representation or the dot multiplication we are using the DOT, that is the dot product. Cross product we are using the cross command here. And for the noise analysis and the noise modeling, there is a need of the random number generation and its representation, and for that purpose we have used the different types of the command like the RAND that generates the single random number between the 0 and 1, rand 1 comma n. In parenthesis, if we write this one, it generates n random number that is a row vector, and all the elements are between the 0 and 1. Rand n, it generates the n cross n matrix with the random numbers between the 0 and 1, and rand m dot n, it generates m cross n matrix with the random numbers between the 0 and 1. And if we write here, the random per n generates a row vector with n elements that are here the permutation of the integers 1 through n. And rand n, it generates the normally distributed numbers with mean 0 and standard deviation of 1 here. We have also represented the different types of the matrix logic operations like the AND, OR, NOT, XR using the MATLAB command. And for the purpose of the rounding and the truncation, we have to use the different types of the functions like the float, seal, round, fix, rational, that is the RAT, here the remainder, REM, GCD, LSM, LCM, and factorization, and whether it is prime or not, that is the is prime. So these are the different numbers which we have discussed during the time of the number calculation. And we have also discussed here the order of the precedence, that the first order of the precedence is given to the parenthesis, second exponentiation, third logical not, fourth multiplication, fifth is the addition and subtraction, and sixth is the relational operations here, and seventh is the logical, and eighth is the logical R. These are the logical operations here. We have we had also used the how the numerical values will be plotted using the two-dimensional plots and the three-dimensional plots. For the two-dimensional plots, we can use the command plot x comma y, and then this here for x comma y we have to use the here the two vectors x and y, that is vector x will be defined, then vector y will be defined. And if we are interested for in a special type of the graph or the representation, then the line specifiers has also to be introduced, so the command will be modified as the plot x comma y line, then line specifier. And here the line styles will be used, here the solid, dotted, and the dash, as well as the dash dot line. And the line colors are the red, green, blue, cyan, magenta, yellow, and the black. These are represented with the different numbers here. And for the different types of the marker, we use the plus sign, circle, asterisk, point, square, diamond, etc. And these all has been covered in the previous lecture, and we have also tested these using these commands in the laboratories here. We can use the fplot command here for the purpose of the function representation and its graphical representation here. And we can use here the so many plots on a same window in order to compare the performances of the different system, using either using the different plot command or using the hold on and the hold off commands here. And for that purpose, we had used one here the polynomial, then its first differentiation, second differentiation, etc. We have also used the formatting commands, like for the purpose of the titles, we are using the title command. Anything which has to be written on the x level, y level, and the limit of the x axis, that is the what will be the ranges of the x axis and y axis, that will be defined by the axis here. And we had also represented that how the legends will be represented, how any text at a particular location will be represented, and how any text will be represented in such a manner that is the movable here. We had also considered one example in order to represent these graphs here. And we had also gone through the different types of the bar representation, that is the horizontal bar and the vertical bar, as well as the plots using the logarithmic and the semi-log and the log-log command here. So these are the different types of the representation which we had used in the two-dimensional, and we had also used the pie plot here. And then finally, we had used these commands in the filter designing and to represent the different types of the graphs and the results. We had also discussed here the three-dimensional plots here for the purpose of the mesh plot and the surface plot here. Here the surface plot, we are using the here the mesh and surf, and if we are interested for the surface plot with contour plot beneath it, then we had to use the mesh C and surf C. And for the any curtain plot, we have to use the mesh Z, and for any flat surface plot along with the property of the color, we have to use the P color. And surface plot that has to be eliminated, for that one we have to use the surf L command. And low level function for creating surface graphics objects, we had used the surface command here. These are the commands which we had used in the three-dimensional plots, and we had also gone through different types of the examples in that one. So these are the related with the implementation. So far we have discussed the designing concepts of the here the different types of the filters, and today we are discussing here the implementation. And as we know, for the purpose of the implementation, we have to use the MATLAB as a language, and then the CCS will be as a code composer studio. CCS will be responsible for the in order to analyze the concept of the quantization and its implementation, and designing will be tested using the MATLAB here. And in the MATLAB, we had used the .m file, .mdl file, and also we had used the different types of the toolboxes here. We had also represented the different types of the basic functions. In the previous lectures, we had also discussed here the DFT and the FFT. So I think this is about the course coverage which we have discussed during our classes and during our the lectures. And we have to cover each and everything whatever has been discussed in the laboratory, starting from the very basic concept, that is what is the signal. We have started our journey from the signal, then we have discussed the system. We had also discussed different types of the signals and system. We had also discussed the designing concepts of the systems. Then specifically, we have discussed the designing of the FIR, IIR. We had also covered the DFT and FFT. And then finally, we had covered this one, is how these concepts will be implemented. And for the purpose of the implementation, we had gone through the MATLAB as a language. And we have tested these designing concepts in our laboratory. So these all are about our syllabus and our lectures which we have discussed. So today, if you have any problem related to this lecture, that is related with the implementation of the the digital filter, then please ask the question. Yeah. If any problem, then please ask the question. And we have also recorded each and every lectures in the video form, and we will try to upload all the videos on your Google Classroom as well as on the YouTube also here. So you can again go through these lectures and hopefully you people have recorded, you people have these lectures. So if you have any problem or any doubt, you can contact for it. So any question or any doubt? I think no questions. So we are just stopping the